It's all there in the Gospels. The Magdalene girl comes to pay her respects, but her mind is a whirl when she finds the tomb empty. The stone had been rolled, not a sign of a corpse. In the dark and the cold, when she reaches the door, sees an unholy sight. There's this solitary figure in a halo of light. He just carries on floating past Calvary Hill in an almighty hurry. Aye, but she might catch him still. Tell me, where are you going, Lord, and why in such haste? I don't hinder me, woman, I've no time to waste. Or they're launching a boat on the morrow at noon, and I have to be there before daybreak. Oh, what can I be missing? The lads will expect me. Why else would the good Lord himself resurrect me? For nothing will stop me, I have to prevail. Through the teeth of this tempest, in the mouth of a gale, may the angels protect me if all else should fail. And the last ship sails, or the roar of the chains and the cracking of timbers, the noise at the end of the world in your ears, as a mountain of steel makes its way to the sea, and the last ship sails. It's a strange kind of beauty. It's cold and austere, and whatever it was that you've done to be here, it's the sum of your hopes, your despairs and your fears, when the last ship sails. Well, the first to arrive saw these signs in the east, like that strange moving finger at Balthazar's feast, where they asked the advice of some wandering priest, and the sad ghosts of men whom they thought long deceased, and whatever got said, they'd be counted at least. When the last ship sails, oh, the roar of the chains and the cracking of timbers, the noise at the end of the world in your ears, as a mountain of steel makes its way to the sea, and the last ship sails. And whatever you promised, whatever you've done, and whatever the station in life you become, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and whatever the weave of this life that you've spun, on the earth or in heaven or under the sun, when the last ship. Aye, the footmen are frantic in their indignation. You see, the Queen's took a taxi herself to the station, where the porter's surprised by a lack of royal baggage. Bustle her and three corgis to the rear of the carriage, for the train it is crammed with all Europe's nobility, and there's none of them famous for their compatibility. There's a fight over seats, I beg pardon, your grace, but you'll find that one's mine, so get back in your place. Ah, but where are they going? All the porters debate. Why, they're going to Newcastle, and they daresn't be late, for they're launching a boat on the tiny high tide. And they've come from all over, from far and from wide. There's the old Dalai Lama, aye, and the Pontiff of Rome, every palace in Europe, and this Nienburger home. Here's the Duchess of Cornwall and the loyal Prince of Wales, looking crushed and uncomfortable in his top hat and tails. Way, they haven't got tickets. Come now, it's just the detail. There was no time to purchase it, and one simply has to prevail. for we'll get to the shipyards, or we'll end up in jail when the last ship sails. Oh, the roar of the trains and the cracking of timbers, the noise at the end of the world in your ears, as a mountain of steel makes its way to the sea, and the last ship sails. And whatever you promise, whatever you've done, and whatever the stationary life you become, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and no matter the weave of this life that you've spun, on the earth or in heaven or under the sun, when the last ship sails, oh, the roar of the chains and the cracking of timbers, the noise at the end of the world in your ears, as a mountain of steel makes its way to the sea, and the last ship
again. Say woof again!
I've got one that can see.
This is my kung fu, and it is strong.
See you later!